Good day, ladies and gentlemen. Today we are talking about one of the most interesting modes regarding the High Middle Ages in the medieval two kingdoms, that is Bellum Crucis 7. Bellum Crucis 7 is a total overhaul, that means both the campaign map and the units are done from are completely redone. So it deals, it starts in the time of 1155, during the era between the Second and the Third Crusade, actually just after the failed Second Crusade in the Holy Land, and revolts around 30 factions. It has one starting date, and here we have the factions. Several of them actually do exist in vanilla medieval 2, such as Kingdom of England, Scotland, Poland, Hungary, Denmark, France, Holy Roman Empire, Sicily, the Byzantine Empire, Venice, Portugal. The rest of them actually are more accurate historical depictions, such as Kingdom of Castile León, not yet, of course, Kingdom of Spain, that is at the end of the 15th century. Kingdom of, we have Principality of Vladimir, two Russian factions. The other one is Republic of Novgorod. We don't have a generic Turkish faction, but we have the Sultanate of Rum. Also, we have the Khanate of Volga Bulgaria, the Muslim Turkic faction in today's southern Russia. We have the Abbasid Caliphate, which at the time was dominated by Turkic warlords. And the Abbasids were kind of weak by this time, so still nominally rulers of their empire. We have Kingdom of Norway, which is also in medieval 2. We have Kingdom of Georgia, a very powerful and long forgotten faction sitting neatly between the slopes of the northern and southern Caucasus. The Fatimid Imamate Shia Empire in Egypt, and Sultanate of Syria under Nur ed-Din, the Turkic Sultanate in Syria. We have, of course, Kingdom of Aragon, the Cuman Confederation, actually a large faction covering today southern Russia, Ukraine, Moldova, and Romania. It's actually a pagan Turkic faction. Since the mode is Italian, we have a heavy emphasis on the Italian trading city-states, the Republic of Venice, the Republic of Pisa, and the Commune of Genoa. Also, we have a very interesting trading mechanics that we will see later in the game. So let's check to see. This presentation will start with the Byzantine Empire, which is apparently the strongest faction of the time, during the time of the Komnenian recovery. The mod is a complete, as we said earlier, it is actually a complete overhaul. We have brand new units, no more the old units of medieval vanilla. We have also a presentation, it is from the older version of this mod of 6.2. We don't need this presentation. So, let's see how is the map. We have Constantinople, the Byzantine Emperor, one very, very interesting thing. The noble dynasties and the noble houses are also a factor. We have his own Vasilevs and Autokrator, Ton Romeon, the Greek title of the Byzantine Emperor. For some reason, we have the retinue Taticius, but Taticius probably was not alive by this time. He was a general of Alexius Comnenus, his grandfather, the second Comnenian emperor. And so we have a very rich Byzantine roster. We have Monemvasia, which was a kind of fortress, Byzantine fortress on southeastern Peloponnese. Athens, not a very important city at the time. Mainly actually Thebes and Corinth, which were plundered by the Normans of Sicily just some 8 or 10 years before the start of the game, are not depicted, despite the fact that they're silk producing centers. We have Naupactos, we have the second most important city for the Byzantine Empire at the time, Thessaloniki. And here we have one general, that is John, the names are still in Italian, Giovanni, Angelus Ducas, belonging to the Angelus Ducas noble house. One not so, let's say, historical presentation that Kherson does not belong to the Byzantine Empire. Actually, this southwestern part of these Norman domains in northern Africa, they were northern Africa, parts of northern Africa were briefly occupied by the Normans of Sicily. Here we have the Almohad Empire, Sunni Berber Muslim Empire, heir of the Cordoba Caliphate, and actually of the former Almoravid Caliphate. It is representing still the Muslim power in Spain. We have here the three main Iberian kingdoms, Kingdom of Portugal, only recently wrested away by the Crusaders. That means it has still a very important Muslim population. Kingdom of Leon and Castile. And Castile, we have the Kingdom of Aragon. Kingdom of France is just the area around Paris. The Angevin Empire, of course, the very powerful Kingdom of England with its numerous domains in France. We have, of course, the Holy Roman Empire, which due to the gameplay mechanics of Medieval Two Kingdoms, it is not represented historically as a as a collection of different states and all into one emperor, but as a unified state, which is kind of erroneous. But still, at that time, Holy Roman Empire was powerful. We have Kingdom of Denmark, Kingdom of Norway, of course, only the southern part here. And so we go Kingdom of Poland, with much room to expand. Kingdom of Hungary in the middle of Europe, it's already a Christian kingdom. And then the Cuman Confederation, as we saw, it covers a very large and long area. We have the Russian states. This is the Principality of Vladimir. At this time, it occupies also Kiev and Moscow, but the capital city is in Vladimir, and we have the Republic of Novgorod. So it is very, it's very, very beautiful mode. It has very many historical buildings like Basilica of St. Sophia, Palace of Magnavra, the great school, the Hippodrome of Constantinople, I think. It has here the Orthodox Church, you can train also a priest. It is one very, very interesting mode. The game is, the campaign map is still divided between towns and castles. It's kind of weird. For example, you cannot, in the beginning, recruit Varangian guardsmen in the capital, but you can recruit them in the provinces. And what we have more? We have totally overhauled units, which we might have a look. So we'll pick just to see how are these new. A unit, we can pick Sicily and the Almohad Empire, General's Bodyguard, Norman Knights. Actually, we start with this early period. As far as I know, they have also really heavy Norman Knights, Norman Barons. Then they have probably these Muslim archers from Sicily. This unit is not yet translated from the Italian, and the dismounted archers of Sicilian Muslims, which were prominent in the armies, their Italian communal militia, spear militia, this is the Ghibellini, which they are apparently later, Italian spearmen, and so on. Pavis crossbowmen, I think they are somewhat early. There were crossbowmen, but not Pavis crossbowmen this time. Then we have the Almohad. We have the best heavy cavalry of Al-Andalus. We have Mozarab cavalry, Almohad cavalry. They are probably capable of dealing with knights. And then we have Almohad crossbowmen, very nice Almohad infantry, Saracen militia, and peasant archers. Let's see. We have also Jinets, the Almohad Jinets, the characteristic cavalrymen of the Iberian Peninsula. Let's see, which are light cavalry. I think they had also many slaves from Africa using as mercenaries. So we might add them. Saharan Berbers, yes. They are. We have Andalusian spearmen. Wow, there are a lot of AOR units, which are really, really incredible. But the problem is that they are put in the mercenary pool, and as a result, most of the players cannot merely reconnect Cap Nafatun, throwing Naftha battles. Andalusian crossbowmen, another one type of crossbowmen. Okay, we don't need handgunners that early. But truly, many of the units, one of the drawbacks of this mode, many of those brilliant units of this brilliant mode are in the mercenary pool, while normally they are factional. It takes a while to load. So, mainly we have here 13th century armor, so that is kind of ahistorical, but the Great Helm appeared only after the 1220 in this form. Here we have still the old Nazal helmet, and this helmet appeared in the late 13th century. But the other units, let's say the Norman barons, wow! Is among the most beautiful Normans that I have ever seen in Uruguay.
Norman knights!
Norman knights with, let's say, a Byzantine like banner. Very beautiful Norman units. The creator of the mod is from Sicily, as far as I know, and as a result, he took a special care of the Sicilian units. Here we have the lesser nobility. Here we have the Muslim archers of Sicily, very beautifully crafted units, and the foot, their foot, the dismounted ones. Here we have also the Italian communal militia. So it is a total overhaul. So that's it, guys. I will add the link for the download under the video description, since this is one of the most beautiful mods to try. Because it actually represents one era that is covered by not very many overhauls. So let's see also Kingdom of France, which at the time was confined around Paris. Unfortunately, the mechanics, game mechanics of Medieval 2 do not represent very well the feudal nature. King Luigi, that is Louis VII the Young, he belonged to the Capetian dynasty. We have male knights, the earliest form of knights. We have Breton archers, urban militia, and also the feudal knights, which are more armored, like 13th century knights. Henry of Blois, Champagne-Blois dynasty of Burgundy.
Ready and able.
Another one of the Capetian dynasty. And of course,
oui, master.
The Kingdom of France has to fight for its own survival and expansion. It is a huge mode, stretching from Scotland all the way to the Abbasid Empire. And it has also several new factions, which
a worthy opponent.
Otherwise, they do not exist in the normal medieval, in the vanilla medieval total war. And also, it has one very extremely beautiful aspect. The player will be able also to build suburbs of different nationalities, like the Jewish suburb, and many different economy buildings in order to represent the economy of the Middle Ages. It has also several different types of fleet. Let's see if we take one Italian faction, actually the most famous Italian, aside the enormous of Sicily, that is the Republic of Venice, which at the time struck very nice deals with the Byzantine Empire, which were actually deleterious of the Byzantine Empire to the economy of the Byzantine, St. Mark's Basilica. And as we see here, it can also build large merchant galley, moving these ships and routes far away from the capital will enable them to find valuable resources, much like the traders, that will ensure an excellent commercial gain when they return back to the capital. And a large corsair galley, it says, by sending these ships to hunt enemy commercial fleets, they can steal their valuable resources and secure an actual commercial gain when the fleet returns to the capital. Wow! Very, very nice mechanic. Very interesting. Never seen again.
Yes,
in a medieval mode. So that's it, guys. Try it fearlessly. One of the best modes. It completely changes the game. It adds new factions and brand new units, and it is extremely challenging in the campaign. So have fun.